this video, we are going to train the eye to learning how to look to the cultural environment where we are. It's a really complex spot. It's formed of many different layers. You know, look, and we have physical objects around the buildings, we have the people moving around, we have the cars, we have the nature, we have so many issues around that it's necessary, at least in a certain moment, to have a read separately of each one of these layers. We are going to start to read the physical environment. Let's think about the building, how they have been built. Look to that amazing stucco that is wrapping the buildings around. Look to their balconies, look to the tiles. Think about if always has been like that. Think about that probably before they were another type of housing. Right now, probably they are for students that they go to the IE University. So we need to look in a different way how buildings have been built over the years. Another layer that is really important is think about how people live here. Look to the people. Probably some of them are tourists, they are visiting Segovia. Another are from Segovia. Probably they are going to work because of the time that we are in the day. We are early in the morning. Or probably some of them, they are just walking around. And then another layer is the time, the history. This is a place full of history. Imagine that probably most of people here, they are Catholic, but many years ago, they have been Muslims or probably they have been Jewish. So their beliefs have been changing over the years. So it's really important to know that, I mean, of course they are Catholic right now, most of them, but they are some of all these religions that have been passing over the years. This is really powerful. This is a really a powerful situation where you cannot read the cultural environment just from one layer. You need to add all these different layers. And we cannot forget about nature. Nature is here. You can see to the cracks of the walls and how nature, the plants, have been inviting them and has been growing there. This is really interesting. Also to see, for example, how the time has passed through the stones of the aqueduct. The stone has been losing its mass. They are not so big as before. So time is everywhere. The history is everywhere. This is a city that is under a continuous evolution. So we need to read it not just now, at this time of the day. Probably you need to come later, in a few hours. Probably you need to come also at night. Or probably we are just getting closer to summer. Of course you need to come in winter. You need to come in spring. And after that you will get a closer look of where we are. But do not worry. If you want to get more information, because probably you don't have all the information you need, try to talk to other professionals. Try to talk to a sociologist, anthropologist, politologist. They are going to help you. They are going to make much, much readable the environment where we are. In the next video, I will show you how other architects have found inspiration in a cultural environment similar to the one that we are.